everybody. Frankie was here. I started making my way down from Firelink Shrine to head to Blight Town, and I noticed there are items here. Okay, it's the witch outfit. I forgot about that. Yeah, I hadn't seen those before. I actually don't think I've ever gotten the witch set before, but I guess because we summoned her for help on Moonlight Butterfly, which I guess I just haven't done recently on most of my characters I've played. I didn't remember. Anyway, we're making our way all the way down to Blight Town again. I believe if we would have sat down at the bonfire we previously skipped at the beginning, we would actually be able to warp there using the Lord Vessel. But let's see how these poop demons deal. 834, not bad. Again, if we had a plus 15 weapon, we would be able to just completely eliminate them a lot faster. Now, you don't even need the master key to go this way now that we've actually gotten the key up here. So this is for any player who wants to go ahead and head back to Blight Town. Just go this way. Go from Firelink Shrine, go down the elevator, and then just, you know, head down to the Valley of the Drakes. Let's keep going down and down and down. And hopefully not get destroyed by being stun-locked in death. Which, if we got stun-locked in the death at this point in the game, I would feel bad. I would feel embarrassed, man. So, you go down here. Now, I'm not sure what causes it, but I'm pretty sure there's a pyromancer down here. Oh, you might notice I have a lot more souls than I did previously. I consumed the soul of Gwendolyn and the Sanctuary Guardian. I believe that's it. Just so we could level up one more time when we get to a bonfire. She's not here. Okay. What causes... Oh, I think we actually have to get a Pyromancer Flame to plus 10 or plus 15. And there'll be a witch who will spawn there. And she'll ask you, basically, to please make sure to take Ceaseless Discharge and... I guess it was the Bed of Chaos out of their misery? Hopefully you're able to encounter it. I wasn't, though. Normally I twink out my characters in areas like this and help people kill bosses. So, whatever causes it to happen, I don't know. Because I don't get past this actual point in the game. Well, I do, but only at a certain point. I usually kill Ceaseless early on, too. Let's see if I remember how to fight him without getting completely destroyed. Because the thing about Ceaseless Discharge, if you start his boss fight and you run off to the very beginning, slow enough, but fast enough, he'll try to, like, lunge his hand at you, and you can just hit his hand a few times, even with your fist, and he'll fall off and die. Because apparently a being made out of, like, that actually has lava coming out of his body can die from falling into the lava. I guess. Let's see, I think we need to go down. Yeah. We're going to talk to the bonfire. Bonfire keeper? Yes. And we're going to upgrade our essence flask. And after we do that, we're going to kill her. I know it sounds mean, but we want to get that other Estus Flask, Firekeeper Soul. That's what it is. What I'll do ahead of time after that, then, is I'm gonna kill off the, undead guy who's with her. Reinforce Estus Flask? Yes. Yeah, she doesn't talk to us. Not because she's stubborn, not because she's mean, she just can't speak to us. We don't understand her, we don't have, like, the ring. So, endurance again. And not only for the equipment low, but also for the stamina. Let's go ahead and rest in peace, ma'am. I'm very sorry. I know, I'm very sorry, buddy, I know. The poor guy. Okay. I gotta kill him. I feel terrible if I don't kill him right now. Gotta take him out of his misery. In case I do get egghead, I do have an egg vermifuge on me. There we go. Yeah, as you can see, the fire the fire place is now, you know, it's gone. Bonfire is now gone. It will no longer be lit until we go into the next new game. In which case, everything will respawn, you have your normal standings, you still keep your sin points, I believe. So if I killed NPCs, I still have to go to, you know, Ozzy, as I call him, and kind of ask for forgiveness for my sins, or else Dark Moonblade people will be able to invade me and possibly kill me. Still have not found two Titanite chunks. These are the guys you would normally get the egghead from. And the reason I really don't like this zone, you might be able to tell how bright it is. You cannot see a single thing. It is crazy. So what we have to do is we can use flash, sweat, run around here, I'm pretty sure, and are able to make it across the way, but we want to, like, get rid of this lava. So, as such, we have to kill Ceaseless Discharge. I think I did not rest the bonfire back there, so when I do die, or if I die, I'm going to try to keep positive, you know, thought about it. Yeah, we're going to be able to kill it. Keep positive. Yeah, that lag, the frame rate's going to be terrible here. This is the other boss who will not attack you unless you attack it, just like Priscilla. I'm pretty sure there are only two of these in the game. You have to attack it, or you have to basically steal the clothes of its dead sister. It sounds really wrong, but it is kind of wrong. You know, just like you normally loot items, you go forward and you loot the items, and you go, oh, cool, I got myself some cool black robes, and then this little guy over here decides he wants to kill you. How could we have known? But he's sitting here looking over, I guess, mourning. He has, looks like he has a very unhappy face on him. He's mourning the fact that his sister's dead. Poor guy. And what we're gonna do is be disgusting people, give us some fire resist, and start the boss fight. What you do is he'll swing. You get 1, 2, 3. It looks like we can get 4 hits in there. Wow. I thought you only get 2. And then just keep blocking. Stay with him though. If you get too far away, he'll like to use some like magic attacks. Also, you don't have to block it because it looks like right there I was not able to block that. And I took no stamina damage, so it's not like I got, you know, knocked out of it. I almost got flung off the side. I just noticed that. Okay, he's gonna shoot fire at us now. That's not cool, buddy. We're dead. I've never had him walk to the right. It looks like he has a different moveset when he walks to the right, though. That's not right. I don't like that. Okay, we did sit down here. Very good. I'm happy then. So I'm still confused about why did he have that different moveset? I've never had him use that before. Anyway, we'll make our way back to Ceaseless Discharge. And I'm actually happy to say I'm pretty sure I've now died more to enemies than I've died to gravity. So we got that switched around. That's good for us. A little bit less embarrassing that we've died to enemies more now. I think my death total to enemies is 4. And to falling is 3. I know somebody probably has a note. I think I died to Capra twice. And I died to a boss once. Which one was it? No, did I? After Capra, I'm not sure. But you're gonna want to move ahead forward and run. I believe this is when he uses fire attack, like a jerk. No, okay. Well, maybe he is. Yeah, he's using fire attack like a jerk. We're going to want to run past him. Honestly, because, you know, we're wanting to get our items back. Oh, great. Am I stuck here? Okay, good. He'll probably blow fire at us, yeah? Yeah. It's always hard to find out what the heck is up with this boss set, or this boss's moves, like, moveset, whatever you call it, what he does, it's always hard to find out what the heck he's doing. Because some things will, like, cause him to just blow fire at you when you're really up close, and sometimes he'll decide he wants to melee you when you're really close. Just, he doesn't make up his mind. Okay, buddy, come on. Let's go and get some swings in here. I believe, like, last time we can get four. Yes. Okay. And now he's moving again, for some reason, into the ground. And, okay, he's blowing fire at us again. Like, why? Okay. Let's heal up while we're waiting for him to attack, because his attacks are extremely slow. Again, he's using fire on us. For some unexplained reason. The frame rate drops. That's his most powerful attack he has. Okay, now that was just him breathing fire and being a jerk. Alright, anyway. That ceases discharge. A boss, if you can call him that. I know I died to him, but... Yeah, victory achieved. It just shows that the fire is no longer fire, and we can now move back. I'm going to use the Homeward Bone. Yeah, that way we can just run down there faster. I believe this is where we actually get the ring that we're going to actually need. It's like required. Unless you're either using hacks, some kind of unique fire resist, all armor, everything, weird build. As far as I know, it's needed. And for more endurance, we're going to be at like the end pinnacle point of our build. Then we can just stack whatever we want. We can go all into endurance more. We can get some more health all the way to 50. Just 40 endurance is normally what I reach for first. And get 40 in all those two through stats. Now these guys will try to come after us, those two. They're hostile for some apparent reason. But yeah, you can just walk right past them. Now, you might notice friendly faces here. In fact, a good about, what is that, 2, 4, 6 friendly faces we recognize from before? Things to note, they have very, 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 very far aggro ranges, so they will try to attack us from just about anywhere. Let's walk forward a little bit more. I don't want to get one to aggro on me, there we go. Get in the back up. Yeah, as you can tell, oh, I got hit by that. They're not very powerful. I say as I got hit by one, but still, it's a good way just to kill these guys. Just get them out one by one. Ooh, let's not get knocked off the side of the cliff. I love how when we block these guys, it just like sends us flying like this. When we hold our shield. That's what I love the most about the Calamite, the moments where when you fight Calamite, then you can do that. There we go. Okay, we got two coming for us. I don't think flame sweat is gonna affect us at all. But just using it just for the heck of it. Block it, got hit by it twice. What? Okay. I got that on camera, right? For recording, right? I'm pretty sure one of them just flung me into the air and I just plunging attacked him. No. I am recording, right? Okay, I am recording. That was sick. That was cool. I like that. Okay. I mean, you know, that's a normal move you can do. It just, you know, you have to be skilled at the game. I could not talk about being skilled with how I play right now. Being very rusty, dying to ceaseless. At least I got some of my skill back, even though it's not all of it. Let's finish this guy off. There we go. I just now noticed we actually don't even have to go this way. It's Centipede Demon that gives us the ring we need. Okay, I'm gonna stop acting like a turd and not die to, Taurus demons. Some of the easiest bosses in the game when you fight them as boss. But anyway, we're gonna go ahead and start moving forward. Now I know why I wanted to use a Homeward Bone, because I wanted to turn human for the NPC invasion up ahead. So I'm gonna actually go back and I'm going to turn human. I was thinking for a minute I wanted to turn human and then thought, well, no, there's a bonfire up ahead, but I want to be invaded by an NPC. And when you're invaded by this NPC, it actually makes an item drop somewhere, which is an item I want. So let's go ahead and reverse hollowing. We won't care about kindling it because we're not going to be fighting a lot of enemies up ahead. We'll get to a bonfire and then another bonfire. There's not really, that I can think of, there's not a boss we're actually going to need more than 5 Estus on. And if there is, we have our humanities on us. All the way down at the bottom, I say, as I slowly scroll down there. So, we were able to meet the Taurus demons again, as everyone saw, and we did an awesome freaking plunging attack. I like that plunging attack. I like that one. I want to learn how to edit videos so I can just edit that part in. See if I have like a comp of just things I do on accident that are pretty cool. It looks like the Taurus demons do not respawn. However, you might notice another little friendly face over here we've seen before. Hello, my friend. Except this time, somebody is a complete badass. And somebody is a pathetic, weak little baby who dies in 2 swings. Guess who's who? There we go. See, if I had my amazing Great Shield when I fought Cap for the first time, I would never take any damage because Great Shields are amazing and lovely, and they are by far the best items in the game. Read message. Yeah, it's gonna tell me something about an NPC invading me. Yeah, let's walk back now. There we go. Hey, Kirk. Dang it. If an NPC dies like that by falling off a ledge, all you have to do is load game and log back in. As such, where he died at, I believe, if he were to have dropped the item, I think he can drop a shield here. Or did I not wait long enough for after he died? Dang it, I wanted to actually fight him. Okay, I guess I just don't get the item now. But with some enemies that jump off ledges, you can just load out and load back in. Okay, come on, Capras. You know I want to fight you. But come on. Yeah, I can take a swing from you and keep attacking, buddy. If I can get it. There we go. Missed one, and he hit his. Embarrassing. Anyway, we're gonna keep making our way across here. And just note, oh wow, there's like, you know, stuff coming from everywhere. This whole area is a ruin. Well, that is part of the name of the area, but just remember that, because that comes into play a little bit ahead. If I can hit this guy and stagger him. It appears as if my hatred for Capra Demon and wanting to hit him very quickly is actually causing me to take more damage. I would get to play a little bit more defensively. These guys' weapons, by the way, are the weapon they use. It's called the Demon Machete. It's a meh strength weapon. But if you want it, you can kill these guys constantly to farm them. So, now these look a little bit more like poop demons than the other guys did, to be honest, but yeah, these guys are just these guys. They're not very strong, but you know. Okay, now here's where you get to learn about fun time. Put a shield up and block. My weapon broke. You broke my weapon, you ugly, ugly creature. Do we have enough repair powder, and does repair powder repair an actual broken weapon? Or do I have to actually go all the way back? Okay, no, good. Stop spitting that stuff and start fighting me. Okay, buddy, if you just want to die, I will gladly accept your free donation of some souls. Okay, let's rest at a bonfire. I did not expect to have my gear broken there. I guess I let my weapon get a little too low. Let's go ahead and repair everything, even if we don't need to have it actually repaired. Repair equipment as well. It's probably getting pretty low. Stuff we use, mainly. There we go. Reinforced armor, no. Level up. Endurance again. Get 4 more stamina. Very good, because of a ring giving us a lot more stamina. It adds up. Now, you can get more embers around here. I believe it's the Chaos Ember. Well, that's a... Is that like a dead worm? Let's see. 21. Alright, good. I think we'll be able to take out whichever boss is up ahead first. I don't know if it's Demon Fire Sage again, or if it's actually the Centipede. Anyway. Over to the left, if you keep going along there, you'll find a lot of worms. And after all those worms, you can get yourself I think it's the Chaos Ember. It's either that or it's the plus 10 Fire Ember. Which is very good for if you're playing a character that does not level up in, like, other stats. Such as Strength and Dexterity, Intellect, Faith. If you just want to grow up full in health. Kind of like what the Giant Dad build does. Anyway, let's cast Flame Sweat and get hit by this, apparently. So I'm not very smart. Now, we already know from the previous guy we fought that that means it's going to be an explosion. There we go. Explosion. I kind of want to back this guy away from the side of the wall, because the secret to beating this guy, just like the first one we fight at the beginning of the game, is just to stick behind him. Humanity. There we go. So, let's get around behind him. This will hit us, I believe. Let's get back up enough. There we go, we backed up enough. Now he's going to fly up, and I believe that's also a shockwave. Very slight, doesn't look like it's a fire shockwave, however. I didn't mean to roll, I meant to start to sprint. Let's back away again, let him get closer to us if he wants to fight. There we go, let's sprint towards him with his shield raised. If we can get him to do that butt stomp one more time, we would have had him. Block that. Let's unlock and wail on him. There we go. Hit him right through the middle of the legs as he was flying up. And victory achieved. Easy peasy. Demon Catalyst. Okay. So, if I remember right, that boss is actually not even needed. You don't have to fight him. What we have to do is we have to find out again, where is the demon centipede? Is it forward over here and then down? Because we have to kill the demon centipede to get something, it's like the Flamewalker ring. It has some kind of name like that. That will allow us to actually walk on lava without taking an insanely high amount of damage. Now, there's some souls over there. Sadly, in the game, if you don't join the certain covenant, this is actually, yeah, this is the shortcut here. If you don't join a certain covenant in the game before a certain point, these creatures here, you'll find one that'll be like a sunlight maggot. You'll actually find Solaire, the amazing, awesome kind NPC, and he will be hollow. If you want to prevent that, you'll need to look up a guide on it. I haven't done it yet, at least haven't that I remember. It requires joining the covenant of the Fire Keeper, the spider Fire Keeper back there who I killed, and giving her 30 humanity, I believe, to unlock the shortcut over here. And behind the shortcut, you'll find the bug that you need to kill. The sunlight maggot is the name of it. And as such, you'll be able to save Solaire, and Solaire will not turn hollow. And you'll be able to summon him for the last boss fight to help you out in jolly cooperation. But if you don't do that, Solaire will turn hollow and he will try to kill you. Because he doesn't, he loses control of his mind. It's the easy way to say it. So, away from all that sad little junk that we're talking about, let's go ahead and try to take on the Centipede Demon. It's another fire lava-ish based boss. As if we haven't had, two in a row already, let's have a third one. And why not make the final boss filled with a lot of fire? Of this zone, at least, not of the actual game. If we had an actual ending fire boss, I'd be ticked off. You know, this boss is really easy, so. Oh, we can. I never even checked. I never thought of summoning one of those boss fight. I didn't know you could summon Solaire here. Aw, oh, man, so. We killed the lady, so no matter what, he's gonna still go hollow after this. But we'll summon him. Just, for the fun of being together at least one more time. And hopefully looking in this direction will not lag us like it is right now. You ready, Solaire? Let's go, buddy. Three Estus Flask, all we need. I get feelings like, Legend of Zelda Wind Waker from this boss. In Dragon Roost, that boss. Spooky. Anyway, this is Centipede Demon. What I recommend when you fight this guy, run immediately up to the right. Hopefully Solaire will follow us. I never really summon anyone in this boss fight, so I don't know how Solaire will act or if he'll actually follow me. I hope he does, for his sake. But you run over here. Okay, it looks like he is maybe following us. It looks like Solaire is running right into the lava. Okay, Solaire, that's not how you stay alive. That's the opposite of how you stay alive, buddy. What we're gonna want to do is kind of face the boss, that way we can face this wall, because it looks like our frame rate dips down to just very, very, very low when we look towards the lava here, which is what might be like exactly what this entire area is gonna be like. Come on, over here, buddy. Okay, Centipede Demon, do you want to, grow up? Do you want to come over here and fight us? Or do you want to keep acting like a baby? Keep acting like a baby, I'm going to cut off your stinking head, dude. I don't even have enough time to hit the head. Right now, it looks like he's just stuck in a complete chain of just being a complete moron jerk. I swear, I will cut it off. Come to me and fight me. There we go. Was that very hard? I believe he's charging forward. Let's go and attack him, though. Looks like it staggered him. He's jumping up in the air. Let's dash away. You still get hit by it, apparently. But hey, we tried to avoid it. That's fine. We should be faster on our feet next time. I believe we can cut off his tail as well. Yeah, there it goes. But I think it comes to life, doesn't it? Yeah, and we have to hit it. Oh, there goes the ring we need. I did not mean to pop a humanity here. I meant to heal. But it looks like I won't be punished too much for it. I won't die. Keep your shield up. Face towards where he's going to drop at. Hope you don't drop into the lava. Okay. That was Centipede Demon. He does have 50% more increased health because we summoned Solaire. Who, maybe we can look back, but I'm not sure if Solaire was actually that much of a help on this boss. I could be wrong, though. But there we go. Reduces lava damage. See how little we get hurt now when we walk in the lava. The downside is, of course, we have to take off Havel's ring. Now, let's see if I remember which way to go. There's a way we have to go through here. Right through here, I believe it is. It's kind of hard to find. I watch a lot of blind first playthrough people on Dark Souls on Twitch, and usually they get lost here for like 15-20 minutes or so. Yeah, imminent sorrow for sure, dude.
What? Why? After all the searching, I still cannot find it.
Yeah, and sadly, the next time you end up finding him, he would have gone hollow. So, thing about Dark Souls is, your character's there. Your character's this. Your character's, you know, you're made to do what you want to do. And just remember, these are other people's stories throughout the game. Solaire, Sigmire. Even though a lot of the NPCs do meet a grim end in the, you know, in the end, you can't do much to save all of them. It's their lives, it's what they've gone through and done that makes their lives turn out that way. If he gives up hope, he gives up hope. You never gave up hope. Anyway, that's the end of this episode. In the next episode, we're going to venture through the dragon butts and hopefully make our way to the Bed of Chaos, which is the last lord we need to kill before we beat the game. Well, we beat, you know, the last lord we need to kill, then we need to kill the final boss. But I hope you enjoyed. Until next time, have a good one.